Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome at the Foreign Correspondent Club. Today we watched one among the very many documentaries that have been done on Fukushima, but hopefully one of the most successful, most complete. The account that we saw is very much complete, and I think it deserves international acclaim, and especially Japanese acclaim. Now, this documentary is out in Japan since a few months already, but certainly needs more publicity. So we hope that it will be seen in Japan and abroad. We have here two very important lawyers in Japan. Kawai Hiroyuki, who is the author and the director of this movie, and Yuichi Kaido, who is a very famous lawyer, criminal lawyer, very famous also for his engagement against the death penalty. And they are both here to tell us why they did this movie and what this movie means and what is the real situation of Genpatsu here in Japan. By the way, today we should all have a wish. Madame Merkel is here in Japan, and we all hope that she will convince Mr. Abe to do what Germany did, to drop Genpatsu.
Yeah. 弁護士の河合でございます。映画監督もしております。
Good afternoon. My name is Kawai. I am a lawyer and also working as a film director now also.
今日 の映画の本物の映画、今日は実はダイジェスト版なんですけど、本物の方はこれの2倍あります。
And the film which was screened today was actually a digest version. The full length feature is actually double the length of what we had today.
感動的な部分や重要な部分がカットされているので、ぜひ本物の方を見ていただきたいと思います。
And some of the most moving parts of the film and also important parts have been cut from the version which you saw today. So I hope that you will have an opportunity to see the full length film also.
それを見るお気持ちのある方は今日 DVD を持ってきましたので本日お貸しすることができます。
And if any of you are interested to see this, I have brought some copies of the DVD with me today and I would be very happy to lend these copies to you.
はじめに私の経歴を簡単に申し上げます。
First of all, I would like to introduce my own background or profile.
私は帝国ホテルの隣にある法律事務所で所長を務めています。
I am working at the head of a legal office, which is next door to the Imperial Hotel.
現在所属弁護士は31名で、私はそこの所長をしております。
And there are 31 lawyers associated with our office, and I am the head of the office.
バブル期、日本の経済のバブル期には大きな経済事件をいっぱい手掛けまして、いっぱい勝ちました。
I was involved in many financial related cases at the time of the bubble here in Japan and was also successful in majority of those cases.
従って私の本業は経済弁護士です。
And I am originally, or my main profession is as an economic lawyer.
で、他方20年来、原発の差し止め訴訟に取り組んできましたが、もうずっと負けてました。
However, at the same time, I have also for the past 20 years been involved in many lawsuits in regards to nuclear power plants or calling for the suspension of nuclear power plants. However, continued to have unsuccessful rulings in these cases.
それは原発必要安全安心キャンペーンが日本国民に、それから裁判官に完全に行き渡っていたからです。
And the reason for this is that the campaign that nuclear power is necessary and safe and secure was reaching not only the Japanese people but also the Japanese judges and the legal system.
ところが311の事件、福島第一原発事故で国民が目が覚め、裁判官の考えも変わったはずだと私は考えました。
However, following the March 11 nuclear power plant disaster or accident, I believe that the people of Japan woke up, and this also had an impact in changing the opinions of many of the judges here in Japan also.
そこでもう一度原発差し止め訴訟を日本全国で起こそうと決意しました。
And at that time, following this, I decided to once again take lawsuits calling for the suspension of nuclear power plants all throughout the country of Japan.
そして、脱原発弁護団全国連絡会というものをこの海戸雄一弁護士と一緒に結成をいたしまして、約300人の弁護士が入会しました。
And following this, I, together with Mr. Kaido, who is next to me also, founded the National Federation of Lawyers Against Nuclear Power, and now we have 300 members in this association or federation.
そして今日本のほとんど全国の原発について差し止め訴訟が起きています。
And now all throughout Japan there are such lawsuits calling for the suspension of nuclear power plants taking place throughout the country.
その第一の成果が去年の5月21日の福井地裁判決です。
And the first of the results of these, or the time that this came to fruition, was the judgment or the verdict of the Fukui local court on May 21 last year.
次にこの映画を作った理由と目的を申し上げます。
Next, I would like to introduce the reasons or purpose for creating this film.
まず第一に国民に脱原発の知識と気持ちを伝えたい、少しでも広く伝えたいということです。
The first reason was to be able to share more knowledge and also more feeling towards the need for denuclearization, for moving away from nuclear power with the Japanese people.
日本ではいわゆる原発本、原発についての本がいっぱい出てます。700種類ぐらい出ていますが、限界があります。
Recently in Japan, there are many books on the issue of nuclear power. More than 700 different kinds have been published. However, they do have their limitations.
したがって私はビジュアル、映画が有効だと、ぜひ映画で国民に訴えようと思いました。
Thus, as a more effective means to appeal to the public, I decided to use the visual means, thus this film.
その目的は達成されつつあります。
And I believe that this goal is being gradually achieved.
今までに全国で200回以上自主上映がされています。
There have been more than 200 screenings organized by local groups and so on throughout Japan of this film.
これからのも入れると300回以上になります。
And including those which are currently planned, this will be a total of 300 screenings throughout the country.
で、毎回その自主上映はもう驚くほど満席いっぱいになります。
And it's very surprising, but these screenings throughout Japan are almost always completely overflowing or full with people.
この映画はもうすでに一人歩きを始めたと言ってもいいと思います。
And I think that it can be said that this film now actually has a life of its own.
この映画を作った第2番目の理由は裁判官を説得したいということです。
The second reason for creating this film is in order to convince judges.
原発の差し止め裁判というのは記録がものすごく膨大になってスチールケースに2箱も3箱にもなります。
In the case of such lawsuits calling for the suspension of nuclear power plants, of course, there is a huge amount of documents being submitted, many boxes, 2-3 boxes worth of these documents and materials.
裁判官は膨大な書類を読み切れません。その圧力に負けてしまうのです。
However, of course, for the judges, it is difficult for them to read all of these materials which are submitted. It's impossible for them to deal with all of the information.
わけが分からなくなるのです。
And they start to be confused or not know what is going on in these materials.
わけが分からなくなるとどういう行動を取るかというと、権力の言うこと、行政の言うこと、それから権威がありそうな御用学者の言う通りに判決を書くということになります。
And in such cases as this, where they are overwhelmed by the sheer amount of materials, well, what happens then? This means that they tend to lean towards the making verdicts which go according to what the authorities are saying, according to what those in power are saying, according to those experts who are linked with the various powers that be. And these are the kind of verdicts which are made in these situations.
それが私たちが負け続けた理由の一つでもあります。
And this is also one of the reasons for which we continued to be unsuccessful in our lawsuits previously.
私は裁判官が2時間15分スクリーンの前に座って見てくれたら日本の原発の状況が全体的にトータルに捉えて正しい方向の判決が書けるようになると思いました。
However, I believe that if judges could be seated or sit in front of a screen for 2 hours and 15 minutes and watch this evidence, this information, and have this total or overall comprehensive view of the nuclear power plant situation here in Japan, I believe that that would have a great impact on the kind of verdicts which would result.
その目的は達成されつつあります。
And I believe that this goal is also being achieved.
私たちはほとんど全ての原発関係訴訟でこの映画を証拠提出しています。またしつつあります。
We are actually have already and are in the process of submitting this film actually as evidence in the lawsuits which we are undertaking in regards to the suspension of nuclear power plants throughout Japan.
現に今から3週間前に松山地方裁判所での伊方原発差し止め訴訟では実際にこの映画が法廷で上映されました。
And actually just 3 weeks ago in the Matsuyama Regional Court where there is currently the case about the suspension of the Ikata nuclear power plant underway, the film was actually screened within the court itself.
裁判官は非常に熱心にこの映画を見てくれたそうです。
And I have heard that the judge was watching the film very closely.
次にこの原発、日本の原発の問題について私や会堂はもう毎日戦っているわけですが、そのこれからの戦略について少しお話ししたいと思います。
And both myself and also Mr. Kaido next to me are struggling and fighting every day with the nuclear power plant situation here in Japan. Next, I would like to explain some of our current and future strategy on this issue.
まず短期的には仮処分で再稼働を止めたいと考えています。
First of all, in the short term, we are working to, through temporary verdicts, prevent the restart of nuclear power plants.
すでに再稼働が始まりそうなのが鹿児島の仙台、それから若狭湾の高浜、それから四国の伊方原発、それから九州の玄海原発などです。
And the nuclear power plants which are currently in danger of being restarted in the near future include the Sendai nuclear power plant in Kagoshima, the Takahama plant in the Wakasa Bay, in Shikoku, the Ikata plant, and in Kyushu, the Genkai nuclear power plant.
で、私と会とその他地元の弁護士たちで、今、仙台原発と高浜原発、それから大井原発について仮処分をかけていて、もしかしたら勝てるかも分かりません。
And at the moment, the two of us are working together with local lawyers in the areas around the Sendai, Takahama, and Oi nuclear power plants for temporary verdicts to be made in the near future. And we do believe that we can, or we have very likelihood of success in these.
次に中長期的には選挙や映画で世論を より強く脱原発の方向に引き寄せて政府に政策を変えさせていきたいと思っています。
And in the mid to long term, we are hoping that in the lead up looking towards elections and so on, also hoping to engage the public and engage the public opinion to be more strongly in favor of moving away from nuclear power plants so that we can also have an impact in changing governmental policy.
次にこの映画を今後どうするかについてお話ししたいと思います。
Next, I would like to introduce our next plans for the film itself.
この映画英語版を海外に広めたいと考えています。
As we now have the English language version of the film also, we are planning to hold screenings internationally.
そしてすでに海外の映画祭に出品しています。例えばニューヨーク国際人権映画祭とかコソボ短編ドキュメンタリー映画祭などです。
And we are also submitting this film to various film festivals internationally or in other countries around the world, including the New York Human Rights Film Festival and the Kosovo Short Documentary Film Festival.
今日の英語での資料の一番最後にこれから出品予定の映画祭のリストがあります。
And within the materials which we have distributed to today, within the English list, is also a list of the film festivals which we are planning to submit the film to in the near future.
そこで、映画祭で外国の映画祭で金賞を取って、赤絨毯を歩いて、蝶ネクタイを締めて表彰をしてもらって、それの勲章を日本に持って帰りたいと思っています。
And not only are we planning to screen these films overseas, but we are also going to be winning the top awards in these film festivals as well. So very much looking forward to walking down the red carpet in a bow tie and being able to bring that medal, that award back here to Japan.
そして、それを持って帰ってさらに日本で、広めたいと思っています。
And upon bringing that back to Japan, we also hope to continue to disseminate the film even further here domestically also.
最後に外国人特派員クラブのメンバーの皆様方にお願いがあります。
And finally, I would also like to make a request of the FCCJ members here today.
本国で、この映画のこと、それからこの映画の中身のこと、今日本の原発の問題がどうなっているかということを正確に熱心に、 報道をしてほしいと思っています。
First of all, I hope that you can report in your own countries, in your own media as well, the contents of this film and the existence of the film itself, and also accurately and passionately portray what is really happening with the nuclear power plants here in Japan.
それから、友人や家族にこの映画を見るように進めてほしいと思います。
I would also like to request of you that you can recommend to your friends and family also to watch this film.
でこの英語版を貸し出しますので、日本でまた本国で自主上映会をやっていただけるとありがたいと思っています。
And I'm very happy to lend copies of this film to all of you here today as well for holding screenings here in Japan or also in your own home countries too.
どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
So, Kaido Sensei, if you want to say something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.弁護士の海戸でございます、この、 クラブではですね、汚染水の問題の時それから朝日新聞 の、 記事が取り消された時、まあ、この1年間に2回ぐらい出させていただいているんですけれども、まあ、3度目ですけれども今日は河合さんの友人として来ました。
Good afternoon. My name is Kaido. I am also a lawyer. I've had an opportunity in the past year to hold two press conferences here at the club, actually. The first being on the issue of the contaminated water, and the second also on the Asahi Shimbun, the Asahi newspaper issue as well. So this is my third appearance here at the FTCJ recently, but today I'm here as a friend of Mr. Kawai.
この映画については私は構成と監修という仕事をしました、まあ、実際には河合さんと相談しながら、まあ、どういう問題を取り上げて、誰のインタビューをし、まあ、どんな場面を作っていくかを一緒に考えることをやりました。
I was also involved in the production of this film, particularly in discussing or consulting with Mr. Kawai about what kind of issues should be featured, who we should be interviewing, and what kind of scenes should be portrayed in the film.
でまあ、この映画を作るときに、まあ、私がこう、まあ、考えて重要な要素がまあ3つあるというふうに思いました。
And in the process of making this film, I personally believe that there were three particular important points.
一つ目のポイントはその福島原発事故の被害者が置かれている非常に悲惨な状況について、見た人にダイレクトに伝わるようなものにしたいということです。
And the first of these points would be for the fact that those people who are affected by the nuclear power plant, that their voices, that their terrible situation that they are being placedIn now, would be conveyed in a way that would be understandable to anybody who watches the film.
浪江の、シーンや飯舘のシーンが、まあ、それにつながってたと思います。
And the scenes of the towns of 浪江 and the village of 飯舘 is connected to this particular point.
でもう一つはその原発に関してですね、政府やまあその電力会社から流れてくる言説が、事実に基づかない、データに基づかないものであるということの反論です。
And the next point would be to be a counter message or to go against the myths which are being put forward by the government and the utility companies as well, and to show that these myths are not in fact based on data, not based on accurate information.
河合さんが白板の前に立って先生のように書くシーンが結構あったと思うんですけれども、これは大変好評だと思います。
And the scenes in the film, where Mr. Kawai is in front of a whiteboard as a professor explaining these situations have been received very positively by audiences for this particular point also.
でもう一つはやはりその原発を止めていくというその、我々のこの戦いが勝算があるということをですね、勝つ可能性があるということを見た人に信じてもらう必要があると思いました。この大井の判決で勝つシーンが出てきたと思うんですが、まあ、こういうシーンを見ることによって、何らかの働きかけをすれば我々は勝つことがあるんだと、まあ、そういうシーンを入れることによって見た方々からですね、自分はもう日本では原発止めるのは難しいと思っていたけれどももう一度、原発反対 の、 その運動に関わってみようと思うようになったとそういう感想を、いろんなところで上映会したときに聞いております。
And the next point also, in regards to our struggle to stop the nuclear power plants here in Japan, I believed it was very important to show the potential fact that we can win in this struggle, and we can show successes and also how we can achieve this goal in the future as well. The scenes about the successful verdict in the Oi suspension case is for this purpose as well, and I hope that people who see this film are able to take these successes, and while previously they may have believed that this struggle is perhaps too difficult, maybe impossible to achieve, by seeing these kinds of images and these these kinds of scenes, encourage them to once again take part in this movement to build nuclear-free society here in Japan. And I've been hearing from people who have been viewing the film very much that they are having these kinds of reactions.
あの原発を止めるための、まあ、知識によって、あの我々自身が武装する、そして、原発の被害に遭った人たちに対するシンパシーというものを、これをですね広めていく、そして我々は戦えば勝つんだという、まあ、鉄の意志ですね、これを持つことによって、なんとか、まあ、司法の力を通じて、まあ、それ以外の国会なども通じてですけれども、原発を止めていくためにこの映画に関わらせていただきました。ご清聴ありがとうございました。
And in order to stop these nuclear power plants, I believe that also if we can arm ourselves more with knowledge and also ensure that we have sympathy for those who are affected directly by this disaster, and if we can combine this to the iron will and the belief that we can succeed, that we can win, and use methods such as the legal methods and also the diet and so on, then I hope that we can encourage more and more people to be involved in this, and this is the reason which I was also involved in the production of this film. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kaido-sensei. Unfortunately, it seems that we have to be very strict today. They will kick us out in maybe 20 minutes. So any question from the floor, please raise your hand and come to the microphone. Thank you. Gebhardt?
Hilscher, freelance from Germany. I'm encouraged to hear your positive reactions you have been receiving, but there's one aspect where I haven't heard of anything successful yet, which is possible criminal proceedings against people responsible for allowing nuclear plants to operate or for actually running them.It is quite thinkable, thinking of all the damage caused, that this could lead to at least criminal neglect in killing people or causing damage. Have you ever heard of any prosecution office here bringing any charges to anyone in Japan, or have you tried to get anyone to move in that direction?
あの我々あの解散と私ともう一人安田弁護士の3人が弁護団としてやっております福島原発告訴団の告訴というものがあります。この告訴についてはですね、すでに昨年の7月、検察審査会が一度あの起訴相当という決定をしております。これについて今年の1月、あの再度不起訴処分がありましたけれども、再々、起訴相当 2回起訴相当の決定が検察審査会で出るとですね、強制起訴ということになります。対象は勝俣氏、武藤氏、竹黒氏、まあテプコの会長と副社長2人が起訴相当ということで、まもなく起訴相当の決定が出ればですね、この事件について正規の刑事裁判が始まろうとしていると、我々はそれを強く求めて、あのたくさんの書面を検察審査会に出しております。
The two of us up here, and together with another lawyer, Mr. Yasuda, are actually involved in a suit known as the Complainants for the Fukushima Nuclear Disaster Criminal Prosecution Legal Team. So the three of us are forming a legal team which is actually working towards criminal prosecution in regards to the Fukushima nuclear power plant disaster. In July...In July of last year, we went to the initial proceedings for this, and then January of this year saw the second step of the legal proceedings in regards to being able to launch this. The target of this suit is the president and vice president of TEPCO, so Katsumata and Muto.Are being Takeguro, sorry, excuse me. And we will soon be going to the next stage of this suit when we will see whether we can actually launch a full criminal prosecution suit in regards to the Fukushima nuclear power plant disaster. So this is underway at the moment.
その点についてちょっと補足して説明します。
And to add some further additional information in regards to this.
私たちはあんなひどい事件を起こしてこれだけ国民に迷惑をかけた人たちが罰せられないということはありえないことだと考えています。
We believe that if there is no prosecution and no punishment for those who are responsible of having such a terrible disaster forced upon the people of Japan is something that we cannot accept.
僕たちは必ず彼らに刑事罰を科すためにこれからも頑張ります。
And we will continue to make all efforts to be able to make sure that those responsible, that these executives of TEPCO are also brought to criminal proceedings in regards to this.
これは単に刑罰の問題ではなくて、こういうことを刑罰かけないと、また同じようなことを彼らはやるのです。
And this is not only an issue of punishment for what has occurred or the legal proceedings for this, but also the fact that if we do not go through these methods, if this not, is not done, then they will just go ahead and repeat the same things again.
もう一つ大事な刑事告訴を僕たちはしています。それは汚染水を海に流してしまったことについての公害犯罪です。
And in addition to this, we are also undertaking another, vital or important legal suit in regards to this, and this is about the contaminated water issue as well.
つい2週間前にまた新たな事実が発見され、分かって、2号炉の屋根からこぼれ出た雨水、大変高線量の雨水が外洋に、港じゃなくて外洋に直接流されているということが、しかもそれがこの1年続いているということが暴露されました。
And in regards to the suit about the environmental pollution caused by the contaminated water, actually 2 weeks ago, some new information came to light about this. This is the fact that rainwater from the roof of the second reactor at Fukushima nuclear power plant, which is a very highly contaminated, is being released not only into the port area so directly around the nuclear power plant, but actually into the outer bay. And this is something that has been going on for a year, and this came to light just 2 weeks ago.
このことはぜひ外国の記者の方たちは外国に伝えてもらいたいと思います。外国の人たちはなんだかんだ言ってももう放射能は海に流れていないのではないかと思っているかと思いますが、それは全く間違っていて、今も放射能が外洋に公海に流れ出ていっているのです。
And I very much would like to appeal to the international media here today to report about this information of the contaminated water. I believe that many people outside of Japan actually are under the impression that there is not being radioactive materials being leaked into the ocean at this stage, but this is completely wrong. And even now, even today, these radioactive materials are being released not only to the direct area, but to the outer bay around this area as well. And I very much hope that you can report about these facts.
そのことについて僕とカイド氏はまた新たに刑事告訴を第3次刑事告訴をいたします。でその時はまたここで、記者会見をさせていただければと思っています。
And the two of us are also in preparations to launch a third criminal proceedings in regards to this issue as well, and I hope that at that time we can also hold a press conference on the issue here once again.
If I may add a comment on this, Kawai sensei, I think that abroad, probably we have much more information and consciousness of the catastrophic situation of radioactivity than in Japan, mm-hmm. thanks to your press that is not very just to defend our category. Okay, the next question.
Khaldun.
Hello, thank you for coming today. My name is Khaldun Azhari, Panorite News. Very interesting movie, and thank you, I got copy. So I hope you give me the right to use it in my media business. My question is, you mentioned that you are against exporting nuclear power, which is driven by Prime Minister Abe. And I report for Arabic countries, mostly Jordan and UAE.And Qatar and Saudi Arabia and all these countries are having business with Japan to get nuclear power. So do you have any message to these countries right now? Thank you.
ヨルダンとはどこだっけ？
ヨルダン、UAE、サウジ、
カタール。カタールね。僕は絶対に日本から原発なんか買わない方がいいですよ、言いたいです。それはなぜならば非常に日本の原発の安全意識は低いです。 で、第一福島原発事故ってあんなひどい事故を起こしたところで、そもそも売りに行くっていうのは非常に恥知らずだと僕は思います。自分の国でちゃんとできない、道具をですね、外国に売りに行ってどうするんですか。僕の疑問は、もし事故が起きたらどうするんですか、どうやって責任取るんですか、言いたいです。というのは多分ですね、面積条項は契約上は入れるんです。だけどいくら契約条項を入れても、本当に事故が起きたときにその国民は日本のことをものすごく恨むと思います。ですから、あ、ごめんなさい、はい、
I would like to share the message that it would not be good for these countries to purchase nuclear power plants from Japan. This should not be done. The reason for this is the safety awareness or safety consciousness here in Japan is extremely low. The fact that such a terrible disaster occurred here in Japan and yet they're still going to sell this technology overseas is something shameful. Something that cannot be used properly, cannot be controlled in its own country. The fact that it's trying to sell this overseas is something which I believe is, well, nonsense. And thinking about this as well, if an accident were to happen in another country, what would be done then? How would responsibility be taken? Well, it's possible to say that in the contractual agreements between Japan and the countries importing nuclear technology from Japan may be made. Beyond the contract, what would really happen if an accident does happen? What would the people of those countries think of Japan if such a situation did occur?
ぜひ原発なんか輸入しないでですね、自然エネルギー、これからどんどんどんどん発展していく自然エネルギーに注力されることをお勧めします。
And so rather than importing nuclear power plants and their technology, I would encourage these countries to look at renewable energy as a field which is very much developing more and more from now and to focus their energies towards this direction instead.
Jean Dertel and BFM TV from France.You say we want punishment. Yeah, we have already heard that there was some people who escaped punishment. So what sort of things would you like to see them being punished? Because it seems very complicated to understand legally. And as a follow-up of that, I don't know what is the principle of international court, but in the past we had here in 1940-something. But what do you think would be the possibility for the foreign countries to get involved in an international court on this issue of Fukushima? I know it's very difficult. Thank you.
まず現在行われているのは、日本の、その、福島に住んでいた日本国民が、東京電力の役員を、の刑事責任、これは、いわゆる業務上過失傷害、ネグリジェンスですね、っていうんでしょうかね、そういうもので追及しています。もちろん、海洋が環境汚染されていてですね、現実にその汚染された物質が、太平洋を越えて、その海外にまでもたらされたと。でそれによって被害を被った方々がいれば、まあ、その環境汚染について、日本政府なり日本 の、 その電力会社の責任を追及する可能性はあると思いますが、まあ、今のところ そういう動きは起きていない、まあ、そういうことを検討しているような人がいるという噂は聞いたことがありますが、うん、今のところ具体的な動きにはなっていないと思います。
The current criminal prosecution proceedings which are underway is on behalf of the complaints or plaintiffs are residents from Fukushima and also residents from places in Japan affected by the disaster. Mm-hmm. And they are taking the TEPCO executives to court for this responsibility. I have heard about the fact if, for example, if contaminated water which was spreading across the ocean would for example, affect people on the other side of the Pacific, if there were people who could claim of their being directly impacted as a result of this, they would be potential in the future for having such kinds of international suits as you mentioned. And I have heard that there are some people considering such kinds of acts as well. However, I have not heard of any concrete actions towards this yet.
I believe that we have to close here. Just allow me the last question.
何時までですか
45分。
そうですか、はい。
大丈夫もっと。ね、チョンさん。 ダメ。彼女は裁判より力、の権限持って
る。そう、張さん偉いからね。言うこと聞かないと。
Okay, just the last one. I personally just came back from.
彼なんか。
The zone, and the problem is that in Japan from tomorrow, everybody will commemorate rightfully the tsunami victims, but many very few people, especially at high level.Will remember the Genpatsu accident. So, do you think it is proper for Japanese authorities, for the government, to skip this issue, which is a very important issue that worries the whole world, especially if we think that in 5 years we will have the Olympics here? So, you two, what do you think about the decision of the holding the Olympics in Japan? Is it a risk or is it a good chance?
福島から帰ってきたばっかりなんですけれども、今311が4周年ということで、津波の被害についていろいろことされてるんですけども、原発の方も忘れられてしまう、特に政権の方からも特に何も言わないというような方向があるんですけれども、特に5年後にオリンピックを今迎えるということもありまして、そのオリンピックに関するリスク、そしてそれについてお話ししています。
僕はですね、初めオリンピックを東京で20年にやることについては反対でした。
Initially, I was actually against holding the Olympics here in Tokyo in 2020.
なぜならば、オリンピックの前後に、また事故が起きたら、外国に非常に迷惑をかけるからです。
And the reason for this is, should another accident happen, for example, just before or around the time of the Olympics, this would be a huge disaster, and Japan would be responsible for impacting this kind of, impact on other people, other countries around the world.
でも今はオリンピックが来てよかったと思っています。
However, now I am actually, I believe that it is a good thing that the Olympics will be here.
その理由は、オリンピックが近づけば近づくほど、世界の目が東京と福島に集中するからです。
And the reason for this is, as the Olympics become closer, the world's attention will be on Japan and on Fukushima.
うちのアスリートや観光客は、日本に行って大丈夫か?ということを心配し始めると思います。
And I believe other countries will be concerned about whether their athletes, their tourists who would be coming to Japan would be safe.
それはどういうインパクトで働くかというと、日本の原発をとにかく早く安全にしろよ、やめろよっていう方にインパクトとして働くのではないかというふうに私は考えるからです。
And I hope that this would have an impact and influence in saying, well, in order to make it safe for these visitors coming to our country, then this would mean that we would have to move towards stopping nuclear power plants.
これからオリンピックが近づけば近づくほど、日本の福島と東京の放射能の状態、それから日本の原発の後始末の問題について関心が集まると思います。
And I believe that as we do become closer to the Olympics, there will be more and more attention and awareness about the radiation situation in Fukushima and indeed in Tokyo, and also the cleanup situation following the disaster.
福島で、なんか一定の種目をやろうというような提案があるようですけど、僕は非常にそれは無神経だと思います。
I have heard that there is actually a proposal to hold some of the related Olympic events actually in Fukushima, but I think this is something which is, should not, well, it's unconsiderable.
今福島と郡山の線量はどれぐらいだと思ってんだって言いたいと思います。
I would like to ask them, what do they think the dosage, the radiation levels in Fukushima City and Koriyama City are now?
以上です。
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much for coming today, as a token of our...Gratitude, we are issuing a one-year membership, honorary membership.
ありがとうございます。
To the club, Mr. Kaido, Kaido? doesn't need, no, because he's already a member, right? もう持ってるでしょ、Kaido さん。
あ、そうか。
ずっと。
もう、あ、そうか、そうか。
何枚持ってるか。
はいはい。ありがとうございます。
はい。Thank you very much.
それからあと DVD 貸し出ししますので、ご希望の方はおいでください。
And please come and let Mr. Kawai know if you would like to borrow a copy of the DVD, and he is happy to share it with you. Thank you.